Hi, welcome to Duplikium. This tutorial will demonstrate how you can manage multiple master and slave accounts using the trade copier's copy settings and template functions. Copy settings contains the risk factor setting. It's mandatory and copying won't work without it. The risk factor also controls which master a slave should copy. Copy settings option is available on each master and slave account. That is because we can set it up both ways. Please note that master and slave settings are synced, so you don't have to do it twice. We'll show you a few methods you can choose from. We will follow this diagram and set up our cockpit using several methods. Let me show you the slave view method first. Let's click on Copy Settings of Slave A. Then you'll see this form where you'll have to choose where to define your risk factor. Please note that copy settings follow a specific priority. Default setting has the lowest priority and applies at the slave account level only. It'll only take effect when the per master level is left blank. The per master level has higher priority over default. It'll override the default setting if it's filled out. Lastly, the per symbol level holds the highest priority, overriding both default and per master level settings. We want master A to be linked to slave A and use the risk factor auto risk balance with a value of 1 to get the same risk. I will leave the default blank because filling this out will cause slave A to follow both master accounts. I won't fill out master B either because I only want slave A to copy master A. Yes, you guessed it. We will only define the setting on master A. Let's click Define Copy Settings, add a risk factor, and hit Save. Before we move on to the next method, let's touch base on the copier status. You can also set it in multiple levels, but here, the most restrictive value will apply. Let's say you want to turn off something in your cockpit. If you turn the status off on the global settings, it will turn everything off. All accounts will stop copying. If you do it on the slave default level, this specific slave will stop copying from all master accounts. If you turn off on the per master level, the copy between the specific master and slave account will stop. Lastly, if you turn off at the symbol level, the symbol you turned off will no longer copy. You've seen how it's done on the slave view. Now, I'll show you the master view method. It's time to configure the second setup. Let's go to the copy settings of master B. The page is almost the same as in slave view, but you won't see a default option here. We want master B to be copied to slave B using the risk factor fixed lot with a value of 1. We'll define the risk factor in slave B, leaving slaves A and C blank. Let's hit save and we're done. It's time for the third method. In this example, we will use template. Templates are best used if you have many slaves and when your strategy requires constant changes. The idea is you will define all your settings within a template and assign it to your slave accounts. If you need to update the copy settings, you will just need to update the template as opposed to doing it one by one on each account. To create a template, expand the sidebar by clicking the ellipsis icon. Go to Templates. Click on Add Template, create the template name, and define the settings you want. Back in our diagram, we want slave C to follow master A using auto risk balance with a value of 1, and master B using fixed lot with a value of 1. I'll do it exactly like that. Now that I'm done setting up the template, I'll head back to our cockpit and assign the template to Slave C. And that's it! We're done fulfilling the requirements of our diagram using several methods in the cockpit. Before we end this tutorial, take note of the following. Risk factor is a mandatory setting. Without it, a slave cannot follow a master. That said, it can also dictate which master a slave should copy from. Each slave can have different risk factors when copying from a master. Master and slave view are synced, so you don't need to modify your copy settings twice. Just choose which method you prefer. The copy settings follow specific priority. If you set any settings in multiple levels, it will override the previous one according to their priority. You can also set the copier status in multiple levels. Just note that the most restrictive value will apply. Aside from mapping purposes, you can use symbol settings to define specific settings at the symbol level. This is useful if you have certain strategies that require unique approach per symbol. If you have many accounts and your strategy requires constant changes, you can use templates instead, so you don't need to make all the changes on each account. That concludes our video for today. We hope that this video helps you with your account management setup. If you have questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. Have a great day, and we'll see you again next time. Bye!